So let's go over that quickly. So we scout with our 10 file with a viscous chelator, but one of the key things we wanna do is briefly remember, when you're using a hand file, it's a good idea to use a viscous chelator. Once this is accomplished, you wanna make sure you rinse the chamber and irrigate the canal. Now you wanna leave, as the video shows, irrigant in the canal as your lubricant, using the True Anatomy irrigation needle. It's okay if you leave irrigant in the pulp chamber as well. Remember, this here is really passive irrigation that's going to take place during your instrumentation. Next, you're going to grab the orifice modifier, purple handle, and of course stopper. You're gonna run it at 500 RPMs. The next thing you're gonna do is think of waves of motion. One, two, three, out. You're going to do this and make sure that you always clean the debris from the flutes with a 2x2 with alcohol. The advantage to using a 2x2 with alcohol is it not only cleans away the debris, but it also evaporates so you can see the condition of your file, whether there's elongation of flutes or unwinding, as many of you call it. Remember then, you want to make sure you rinse the chamber and irrigate the canal before going to obtain your working length. So once we've completed our coronal modification, we then want to rinse the chamber, irrigate the canal, and then, of course, obtain our working length. This is confirmed with our electronic apex locator, as Shabahang said, 96% accuracy back in 1996. The next thing we want to do after we confirm our working length, we want to make sure that we rinse the chamber, irrigate the canal. Once we've now obtained a coronal modification, our working length, and confirmed patency, we want to confirm our glide path. And we want to make sure we have a mechanical glide path with something that's flexible, and therefore the True Anatomy glide path instrument. This confirms a centered glide path that your shaping instrument will use. After using this, it may take approximately 2 or 3, or maybe 3 or 4 in difficult cases or curve cases, 3 sets of 3. Key. The next thing we want to do is we want to rinse the chamber and irrigate the canal. Once you have your glide path, you are now ready for that shaping. And as we said earlier, you always want to start your shaping objective with the prime instrument. It has a red band and a red stopper and has a tip, as mentioned earlier, of 0.26. Now, using this also at 500 RPMs and at torque, obviously, 1.5. We want to make sure that we do this in a nice, easy, flowing motion, no pecking, no stalling. We want to make sure it's nice and smooth. Once you look at this, you're going to see more debris in your chamber than previous. So what I want you to do is remember, always rinse the chamber and irrigate the canal. In certain cases where you have a small radius, okay, with a great angle, in those cases you want to make sure that you evaluate it and see if you are going to complete with the prime or drop down to the 20. But remember, as I said earlier, once you use the 20, you're actually creating a more predictable glide path at a larger size, and the prime will probably follow over 95% of the time. And then again, now go through, rinse the chamber, irrigate the canal, activate your irrigants as you do, follow your disinfection protocols that you use in your office, and then after that, obviously, prepare for obturation. One of the key things I want to remind all of you, one of the great things about this is, with 2 ports on the True Anatomy irrigation needle, I recommend just grabbing a white plastic surgical suction tip when you're ready to dry your systems after using the ConformFit True Anatomy gutta percha.